DGraph, a graph database that natively implements GraphQL as its query language. When we build apps, our data is often highly relational, requiring deep joins and complex traversals, while needing to scale around the universe with high reliability and low latency. Instead of managing data in tables, columns, and rows, a graph database is structured as nodes and edges. An entity, like an astronaut or rocket, is a node, while a relationship between two nodes is an edge. Not only is this more intuitive to developers, but it's also a more scalable approach when dealing with deep relational data, like a social graph or recommendation engine. DGraph is not the first graph database, but the first to implement GraphQL natively as its query language, which means you can use it in its full capacity with a language that you already know and love. On top of that, it's open source and is the most starred graph database on GitHub. It's written entirely in Go, is ACID compliant, runs fast at scale, can be self-hosted, or hosted in the cloud as a fully managed service. You can get started by pulling the Docker container or by using a fully managed cloud service. What you see here is the dashboard for a free /GraphQL account, which is ideal for an early stage startup. First, we need a schema, which is defined in GraphQL. We have types for astronaut, mission, and rocket. An astronaut can ride on many rockets through missions. Now that we have a schema, we can go to the API Explorer, which is automatically generated for us. We can use GraphQL mutations to create, update, and delete data. When we add a new node to the graph, it returns a unique identifier, which can then be used to create relationships or edges between other nodes. And now that we've populated data, we can view it in the visualizer or make queries against it with GraphQL. Let's grab all the astronauts that have been on a rocket by writing a query that traverses through the missions node. If we're happy with the result, we can use the code exporter to convert it to JavaScript to use in a front-end web application. However, we may want to implement more advanced queries, like a full-text search, for example. We can do that by going back to our schema and making that field searchable. That will automatically add an index annotation to our GraphQL schema. And that's all it takes to build a full-text search engine. This has been DGraph in 100 seconds. If you want to see more short videos like this, make sure to like and subscribe, and let me know what you think about DGraph in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.